Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Aspiring student, let's discuss one of the important topic in reasoning and most scoring topic also, that is puzzle and seating arrangement. If I talk about the weightage of this topic, in prelims we will see 20 to 25 marks from this topic, my dear friends, and in mains we will see 25 to 30 marks from this topic. Okay, so this is very important and easy also. Okay, very important and easy also. So before solving the puzzle of today, let me know you some important factors of this puzzle and seating arrangement. So that is how to solve this. So see, if you take any type of puzzle and seating arrangement, so there are three factors which helps us to solve any type of puzzle and seating arrangement as soon as we can. The first one is approach of puzzle, approaching of the puzzle, and next drawing the hints from the body of the puzzle, and finally we have cross checking the hints. Okay, cross checking the hints. These three are very important factors to solve any type of puzzle as soon as we can, my dear friends. Okay, so these three are very important factors to solve any puzzle, my dear friends. So if you are good at approach and cross checking, then you can solve the puzzle as soon as you can. Okay, so now let's discuss the puzzle of today. So here is the puzzle of today, my dear friends. So it is a triangular based puzzle, triangle inside a triangle. Okay, so see friends, in an event, all the 12 students, so these are the 12 students from A to L of the college are made to sit in two triangles. So 6 students sitting in the inner triangle facing outside. So the students sitting in the inner triangle, they are facing outside, and the other students sitting in the outer triangle are facing inside. So the other students who are sitting in the outer triangle, they are facing inside. Okay, and no two alphabets sit adjacent to each other. Okay, so this is very important. And no two alphabets sit adjacent to each other, my dear friends. Okay, and this is called the body of the puzzle, friends. From this, we draw the hints. So we should draw the hints very precisely in short manner. Okay, so see. From this part, I have drawn already the hints. Okay, so let me tell you how to draw this. D sits opposite to one whose alphabet number is 7. So what is the 7? That is G. So G value is 7, my dear friends. Okay, so now D is sitting opposite to G, okay, whose alphabet number is 7. Okay, and faces inside. So they are talking about this D only. And D is not adjacent to H. So D is facing inside and it sits opposite to G, and D and H are not adjacent to each other. Okay, and next K sits on inner triangle. So K is sitting on inner triangle. Okay, K is sitting on inner triangle. H is opposite to B. So H is opposite to me means H and B are facing each other. Next, K does not sit in the middle of the triangle. So K is not sitting in the middle means that K should be at one corner. So that's why I have directly placed it. K is sitting at one corner. Okay, K is sitting at one corner. Next, J sits at one corner. So J is sitting at one corner. And A and J, A is adjacent to J. So A is adjacent to J, my dear friends. So A is adjacent to J. And next, C sits in the middle of outer triangle. So C is sitting in the middle of outer triangle, my dear friends. Okay, C is sitting in the middle of outer triangle. I faces C. So I is facing C. That means I and C are facing towards each other. B, who is adjacent to L? B, who is adjacent to L? So B and L are adjacent to each other. Sits at corner of inner triangle. So this B is sitting at the corner of inner triangle. Okay, B is sitting at the corner of inner triangle. E facing outside. So E facing outside. So the triangle inside. So here we have two triangles like this. The inside triangle is facing outside. So E facing outside means, so that E should be on inner triangle, my dear friends. Okay, E is facing outside and sits at one corner. Okay, sits at one corner. So E is in the inner triangle and sitting at the corner. Okay, sitting at the corner. So if you observe here, we have already got the inner triangle, that is C. E is one corner, in the inner triangle, and again B is one corner on the inner triangle and K is one corner on the inner triangle. Okay, so see, first of all, this is how we have to draw the diagram, friends. Two triangles. So this is inner triangle and this is outer triangle. So inner triangle is facing towards outside and outer triangle is facing towards inside. Okay, and see, from this, just now I told you that E, B and K, these two are sitting at one corner of inner triangle. So see, I have placed here. So B is here, K is here and E is here. So you can place anywhere, nothing issue with that. Okay, you can place anywhere. And what they told, my dear friends, H is opposite to B. After that, after placing B, K and E, this B is opposite to H, means that H comes here. Okay, H should be come here. And after that, what we have means L sits at the corner of, sorry, B, who is sitting adjacent to L, sits at the corner. So already I have placed B here, then I have to place L adjacent to B. So see, where can I place L here? Here or here? I can't place L here because L and K, these two becomes adjacent again. Okay, so that's why I can place L here. Okay, so H is here and L is here. Okay friends, H is here and L is here. So see here. So I have placed H here and L here. And next, what we have, my dear friends, that is, see, J sits at one corner. J sits at one corner and A and J are adjacent to each other. A and J are adjacent to each other. So here all the corners are filled with one students. So here the left corner says this one and this one. Okay, this one and this one. See, if I place J here, if I place J here, then A comes here or here. Okay. So see, I will erase everything and draw neatly. See, if I place J here, A should be here or A should be here. Okay, A should be here or A should be here. So if I think this A is here, if I think this A is here, now I will erase this one. Okay, I will erase this one, and C should be here and I should be here. Okay, C should be here and I should be here, because I is facing C and C sits in the middle of outer triangle. So this is outer triangle and C is sitting in the middle. Okay, and C and I are facing each other. And next, what I have left with D, sitting opposite to one whose alphabet is, whose alphabet number is 7. That is, D is facing G. Okay, and faces inside. So they are talking about D only. So D should be face inside. So if I place D here, there is no space for G. If I place D again here, there is no space for D. G. Okay, there is no space for G. Whether if I place, now if I think J is here and A is here, okay, I can place only one person here. That is one pair, either D, G or C, I. Either D, G or C, I. Okay, so that's why, what you confirmed from this? This. See, this J should not be placed here, my dear friends. Okay, this J should not be placed here. Now, what the corner left for J? That is this one. This one. So, if I place J here, then A can be here or A can be here. Okay, A can be here and A can be here. Now, see, if I place A here, then there again we have only left with one pair. Okay, so that's why we have confirmed that J is here and A is here. And now D is not adjacent to H, means then I can place D here and G here. Okay, D is not adjacent to H, means here I have forgot to type here. Okay, so you can see here. So see here, D is not adjacent to H. Okay, I forgot to type here. So J is here and A is here and D is here and G is here, because G is facing opposite to an alphabet whose number is 7. That means G. And C is here and I is here, because I and C are facing each other. Okay, and C sits in the middle of outer triangle. So C is sitting in the middle of outer triangle. Next, only one person left. What that is? F. F. Okay, this one. So this is the complete set of students sitting in the two triangles. Okay, friends. Now you can see here this one. So see, J is sitting here and I have placed A here. Then I left with two pairs. Okay, so here also I left with two pairs. So that's why I placed C here, because D and H, these two are not adjacent to each other. So that's why I placed C here and I here and D here and G here. And only one person left, that is F. F is here. And you can compare that no one is adjacent to each other. So see, friends, CF not adjacent, CH not adjacent, HA is not adjacent, AF, AJ is not adjacent, JD is not adjacent, D and F is also not adjacent. EG is not adjacent, EL, BL, BI, IK, GK. So these people are not adjacent with each other. Okay, this is how all the 12 students sit in the two triangles, my dear friends. So this is very important for your exam, either it is RBI assistant prelims or SBI prelims. Okay, friends. So thanks for watching. Thank you. If you like my video, please like it and share with your friends, and do subscribe to my channel, Aspiring Student, my dear friends. Thanks for watching. Thank you.